Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, start with him, because he's the oldest of those four famous imams. The first of them is Abu Hanifa Nu'man bin Thabit rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him, whose companions, his friends, they have narrated from him various sayings and diverse warnings, all of them leading to one thing, the obligation to accept the hadith. The obligation to accept the hadith and to give up following the opinions of the imams which contradict that. Yes, if the opinion of your sheikh or your imam or your maulana or your mufti, it is according to the sunnah, then follow it. Because you're not following him, you're following the Prophet ﷺ. But if the opinion of Abu Hanifa or Malik or Shafi or Ahmad or any other scholar, it contradicts the sunnah. What did Abu Hanifa say about that situation? What should we do? Listen to this. And again, every single thing is referenced. Number one, when a hadith is found to be sahih, إذا صح الحديث فهو مذهبي, then that is my madhab. Who's saying that? Abdul Aziz? Huh? Not Abu Umar Abdul Aziz, no. Abu Hanifa Nu'man bin Thabit al-Kufi, rahimahullah, he says, إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثِ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. When a hadith is authentic, sahih, then that's my madhab. You're going the day of judgment, and Allah says, look at your prayers, worthless. See, Ya Rabbi, I was following Abu Hanifa. Allah says, call Abu Hanifa here. Abu Hanifa is brought. You are the one who taught him this. He says, La, Ya Rab. I said some words, but I also said at the same thing, at the same time, I'm a human. When you find a hadith is authentic, follow that. That's my madhab. So if you're a Hanafi, you have to be a Salafi. Who are the Salafis? Very briefly, those who follow the Salaf, the Sahaba. Those who follow the Sunnah. Or if you're a Hanafi, be a Sunni. If you don't want to call yourself a Salafi, be a Sunni, somebody of the Sunnah. Because Abu Hanifa was a proper Sunni. Okay? It's a good thing about books. It's a good thing about the scholars of hadith. Everything is referenced again. So you don't accuse him and say, oh, maybe the sheikh is making up something. No, he's not making up anything. Your mind is acting up. Number two, he says, Abu Hanifa, it is not permitted for anyone to accept our views, meaning the scholars, if they don't know from where we got them. He's talking about everybody. Don't follow us because Abu Hanifa is speaking for all the scholars, because all scholars, they are the same. They try to follow the truth, but they don't know any. We have to know something, brothers. There's no single person who knows everything. No, this, it doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. And if you give examples, we'll give so many examples. Even the Sahaba, they had some things which they didn't know. They had to go and learn. This point, it means briefly, don't blind follow us. In one narration, Abu Hanifa said, it is prohibited, haram, for someone who does not know my evidence to give verdicts on the basis of my words. It is haram for somebody who does not know how I got my opinion to give a fatwa according to my opinion. Abu Hanifa is saying to you, go and learn. Don't just blind follow me. Another narration adds, for we are mortals, we are human beings. We are not infallible, we make mistakes. We say one thing one day and take it back the next day. And that is the sign or the trait of pure Ahlul Sunnah. I'll say something today, tomorrow somebody says, no, what you said is wrong. There's a hadith which says what you say is wrong. I have to come tomorrow and say, you know what, guys, I was wrong. And this is what Abu Hanifa says to us. I am a human being. I might say something today and tomorrow I'll take it back. Because now I have learned that is wrong. People, they learn every day. That's how the Muslims they are. That's how the Imams were. In another narration, Abu Hanifa says to his main student, Ya'qub. He says, Abu Yusuf Ya'qub, rahimahullah, al-Qadhi. Wayhaka ya Ya'qub, woe to you. Do not write down everything you hear from me. For it happens that I hold one opinion today and I reject it tomorrow. or hold one opinion tomorrow and reject it the day after. Don't just write everything I say as if it's wahi, it's revelation. Take it easy. Number three, Abu Hanifa says, when I say something contradicting the book of Allah or what is narrated from the Messenger of Allah, meaning the Sunnah, then ignore my sayings. Ignore me. If you say this today in some masajid, you'll have to take me to the emergency right now, Scarborough General. Abu Hanifa? No! He's saying this, not me. And all of the madhahibs, by the way, there's people who are very tough, and the Shafi'is, the Malikis, they're ready to kill you.